Hello students, are you all ready for the class? Today in this module you are going to learn about chemicals that can be prepared from common salt. The chemical name of common salt is sodium chloride and its chemical formula is NaCl. You have already learned about the preparation of sodium chloride, how it can be prepared. Let's recap. So you know that this salt, sodium chloride, is prepared by the reaction of hydrochloric acid HCl and sodium hydroxide NaOH. So the equational form of it can be written as HCl plus NaOH gives rise to NaCl plus H2O. This salt which is obtained is known as common salt since it is used widely in various places. It is known as a common salt. So this common salt thus obtained is an important raw material for the production of various materials which we use in our life, like sodium hydroxide, baking soda, washing soda, bleaching powder, etc. Now let's get into today's topic, that is preparation of chemicals from common salt. Okay, let's see now the preparation of sodium hydroxide. The chemical formula of sodium hydroxide is NaOH. Now to prepare this sodium hydroxide, required chemicals are NaCl common salt, H2O, that is water. So here when sodium chloride is dissolved in water, it is known as brine solution. So this is a new point which you should remember, that is sodium chloride when it is dissolved in water, it is known as brine solution. Students, we are going to use this brine solution as the chemical to conduct electrolysis. So here when electricity is passed through the aqueous solution of sodium chloride, it decomposes to form sodium hydroxide and the reaction is represented in the following equational form. Let's see, 2NaCl plus 2H2O gives rise to 2NaOH plus Cl2 plus H2. Now let's see how this reaction has taken place. When NaCl decomposes, it releases Na plus and Cl minus ions. So whenever any compound undergoes and releases positive and negatively charged ions, the negatively charged ion is known as anion, positively charged ion is known as cation. So the released anion in the reaction, that is chlorine, moves towards anode. Anode is positively charged electrode and hence it attracts the negatively charged ions. So chlorine ions moves towards an anode, and at the same time water molecule also dissociates and it releases H plus and OH minus ion. So the released ions from water are H plus and OH minus, and the released ions from NaCl are Na plus and Cl minus. So here Na plus from NaCl and OH from water combined together, resulting in the formation of NaOH. And the hydrogen ions, those which are released from water molecule, they can be collected at cathode. So in this reaction, the formed products are chlorine and alkali, that is NaOH. Hence, this process is known as chlor-alkali process. What is this process known as? Chlor-alkali process, because chlorine is released along with that alkali. An alkali, NaOH, is also released. Hence, this process is known as chlor-alkali process. Okay, students, see this figure now. Now here in this figure, you can see that the main products which are prepared from chlor-alkali process are hydrogen gas, chlorine gas, and NaOH. Now, these products which are obtained in chlor-alkali process are useful in many ways. So let's see what they are. Hydrogen gas, which is released at cathode, can be used in the manufacture of various fuels, and This hydrogen gas is useful in the preparation of margarine. Margarine is a butter substitute, and this is also useful in the preparation of fertilizers in the form of ammonia. Now let's see the uses of chlorine. Chlorine, which is released at anode, is useful in water treatment. How this is useful, you will be learning further. And the chlorine gas is useful in the treatment of swimming pools, PVC pipes, that is polyvinyl chloride pipes. Since these pipes are made up of chlorine, these pipes are known as PVC pipes, and in the manufacture of these pipes, vinyl chloride is used, and it is a polymer, hence its name is PVC, polyvinyl chloride. Chlorine gas is also used as a disinfectant, and this is used as a pesticide and CFC, means chlorofluorocarbons. In the preparation of chlorofluorocarbons also, it is useful. Now, the uses of NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide. This is used as degreasing metals in the manufacture of soaps and detergents, in the preparation of paper and artificial fibers. Again, in turn, these are useful, like hydrogen and chlorine are useful in the preparation of hydrochloric acid, and this hydrochloric acid is useful for cleaning steel, ammonium chloride manufacture, medicines, and in preparation of cosmetics they are useful. Chlorine and sodium hydroxide together, they are useful as a bleach for household bleaches, and for bleaching the fabric materials also they are used. So the products that are obtained during chlor-alkali process are also useful, and you have seen the uses of them. Now let's move on to the next. Preparation of bleaching powder. Chemicals required for this are dry slaked lime, CaOH twice, and Cl2, that is chlorine. Let's see how this bleaching powder is produced. This bleaching powder can be produced by the action of chlorine gas on dry slaked lime. So when chlorine gas is made to react with calcium hydroxide, it forms bleaching powder, and also water molecule is released. So here this can be represented in the equation as follows: CaOH twice plus Cl2 gives rise to CaOCl2 plus H2O. So here CaOH twice is dry slaked lime made to react with chlorine, then it forms CaOCl2, that is calcium oxychloride. The general name of this is bleaching powder, and its chemical name is calcium oxychloride. So the formed bleaching powder, which is obtained in this reaction, is generally yellowish white powder. And how this bleaching powder is prepared? By the reaction of calcium hydroxide with chlorine, that is dry slaked lime. When it reacts with chlorine, it forms CaOCl2, calcium oxychloride bleaching powder, and H2O. Uses of bleaching powder. Let's see how the bleaching powder is useful in textile industry. Generally, in textile industry, the bleaching powder is used to bleach cotton and linen cloth. So during the production of the material, they take this cotton and linen cloth in their natural form. So all the raw materials in their natural form are known as Greek material. So this material has its own natural color, odor, and impurities. Due to the presence of these impurities, they are not suitable for clothing. Hence, the impurities has to be removed. To do that, they use bleaching powder. But how the impurities are present on the raw material is, during the production, the farmers use different types of fertilizers, pesticides and all. So due to the present use of all these pesticides and insecticides, impurities remain on the cloth. So to remove them, they use the bleaching powder. So in this way, The bleaching powder is helpful in textile industry to bleach cotton and linen cloth. Continuation of uses of bleaching powder. So here the bleaching powder is also used in paper producing industry. In what way it is used is, it helps to bleach the wood pulp in paper producing industry. So bleaching of wood pulp is a chemical process. This chemical process is done to lighten the original color of the pulp and whiten the pulp. So what is the use of bleaching the wood pulp is, here when the pulp is treated with bleaching powder, it undergoes a chemical process, and in this process the color of it is lightened and the pulp is whitened, so it looks more whiter and its appearance also becomes fine. So in that way the quality of the paper increased. So in paper producing industry, bleaching powder is used to bleach the wood pulp. Let's see the other use. Bleaching powder is used in laundry for bleaching washed clothes. In chemical industry, it is used as an oxidizing agent. And bleaching powder is used for disinfecting drinking water by making it free of germs. The water which is supplied for drinking is purified, and in its purification, this bleaching powder is used to kill the germs. So in that way, it is used as a disinfectant. Bleaching powder is also used as a reagent in the preparation of chloroform. So here, bleaching powder, in other way also, it is used to prepare chloroform. The formula of chloroform is CHCl3. This is also called as trichloromethane. CHCl3 is trichloromethane, or generally it is used as chloroform. Common name is chloroform. And where this chloroform is used is in medical purpose. In medical purpose it is used as anesthesia, and as a sedative also it is used. Sedative, the purpose of this is it calms the certain systems of our body, so that when surgery goes on, it calms down the systems and the surgery goes on smoothly. The other use of the chloroform is, it is also used as a refrigerant. So in this way, the bleaching powder is helping us to produce different products, like in paper industry, textile industry, in laundry, as an oxidizing agent, in chemical industry, as a disinfectant, and as a reagent in the preparation of chloroform. Preparation of baking soda, that is NaHCO3. NaHCO3 is the formula of baking soda, and it is called as sodium hydrogen carbonate. The chemical name of baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3. The required chemicals to prepare baking soda are NaCl, common salt, H2O, water, CO2 is carbon dioxide, and NH3, that is ammonia, are the required chemicals for it. The reaction what happens when these chemicals are added is shown in the equational form. NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3 gives rise to NH4Cl plus NaHCO3. So what are the products formed in this reaction are NH4Cl, that is ammonium chloride. NH3 is ammonia, NH4Cl is ammonium chloride. So here one more molecule of HCl is added from these reactants and forms NH4Cl ammonium chloride. Along with this, NaHCO3, that is baking soda, is also prepared. Now let's see the uses of baking soda. Uses of baking soda. It is used as an ingredient in antacids, means baking soda is useful to prepare antacids tablet, so it is used as an ingredient in them. This is also used as soda acid in fire extinguishers, two puts of fire. It acts as mild antiseptic. So it is used as an antiseptic also. Being alkaline in nature, since baking soda is alkaline in nature, it neutralizes excess acid which is present in the stomach and gives relief for us. It is used in kitchen for making tasty crispy snacks, and it is added with some food items to cook them faster. So in this way, the baking soda is useful in multiple ways. Now let's see the other preparation of baking powder. This baking powder is prepared from baking soda. Now let's see how it is prepared. This can be prepared by treating baking soda with mild edible acid such as tartaric acid. So here, how the baking powder is prepared is, when baking soda is treated with edible acid, mild edible acid, then it forms baking powder. Let's see how it is. When baking powder is heated or mixed in water, the following reaction takes place. Let's see. NaHCO3 plus H plus, which is released from any acid, combines and forms carbon dioxide, water and sodium salt of acid. So this released carbon dioxide, which is produced in this reaction, causes bread or cake to rise up, making them soft and spongy. So in this way, this baking powder is useful in kitchen. How it is useful is, the carbon dioxide gas which is released in reaction when baking powder is heated or mixed in water, it releases carbon dioxide gas. This carbon dioxide gas causes the food items in which it is mixed up, causes them to rise and makes them soft and spongy. Now let's see the preparation of other chemical, washing soda, Na2CO3 10H2O. So how this is prepared is, recrystallization of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate Na2CO3, when it is crystallized, it gives washing soda. This washing soda is a basic salt. Let's see the equation. Na2CO3 plus 10H2O gives rise to Na2CO3 10H2O. So water molecules are added up to it and forms washing soda, Na2CO3 10H2O. What is the formula of washing soda? Na2CO3 10H2O. Let's see the uses of it now. Uses of washing soda. It is used in the manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax. This borax is a chemical which is used for medicinal purpose to treat cuts and wounds. Washing soda is used as a cleaning agent. It is used in many industries like glass, soap and paper industries. Washing soda is used to remove permanent hardness of water. This permanent hardness of water is due to the presence of certain ions like chloride, sulfate and nitrates. So due to the presence of them, the hardness of the water remains, means they doesn't give out lather when we treat them with detergents or soaps. So that permanent hardness of water can be removed using washing soda. Students, till here you have learnt about the chemicals prepared from common salt. So let's recap. Sodium hydroxide, NaOH, baking soda or cooking soda, that is NaHCO3, baking powder, washing soda, Na2CO3 10H2O, and bleaching powder, CaOCl2. These are the compounds which are prepared from common salt. Few of them are salt and they appear in crystals. So here the next topic is about to find out about the crystals of salts. So the salts which appear in crystal are known as crystals of salts. Generally, these which appears to be as crystal, they may not be macroscopic crystal. They may not be a large crystals of compounds, but it contains fine crystal particles, like common salt we say. It is a fine crystals which contains very minute crystals in it. Now, here we are trying to find out these crystals of salts, are they really dry? Because when we touch them, we feel that they are dry. Now here, this activity is to know the crystals of salts are really dry. Let's see. The apparatus required for this are test tube holder, boiling tube, Bunsen burner. Required chemicals are water, copper sulfate crystals. Water you know very well. Copper sulfate crystals are blue in color. So let's see the activity. So here, this is a boiling tube. The difference between a boiling tube and a test tube is that this boiling tube is mainly designed to heat the contents over the flame, whereas a test tube is used to take certain chemicals or liquids to transfer the substances during a reaction. The test tube holder. Now, you can see in the boiling tube, some chemicals are present, and that chemical is copper sulfate crystal. As I said, copper sulfate crystals are blue in color, so it is blue in color. But above to it, you can see some droplets. They are water droplets. Now, let's see how these water droplets are produced. Procedure to find out the crystals of salts are really dry. Take a few crystals of hydrous copper sulfate in a dry boiling tube and heat it. Here I have mentioned that hydrous copper sulfate. Hydrous copper sulfate means the compounds which contains water in them. They are known as hydrous compounds. Here I have taken hydrous copper sulfate. So these copper sulfate crystals, when they are taken in a dry boiling tube and heated, the color of it turns to white. And you can also see water droplets on the sides of the boiling tube. Why the water droplets have formed in this reaction is, here when we are heating copper sulfate, it is giving out the water molecules, and these water molecules, due to condensation, they settle on the sides of the test boiling tube. The color of the copper sulfate after heating becomes white. Water droplets in the boiling tube are seen due to condensation of water crystallization from copper sulfate. Now let's see what happens after it. Add 2 to 3 drops of water on the sample of copper sulfate that is obtained after heating. So here, when you are taking a hydrous copper sulfate and heating, it turns to white color. Take that white sample of copper sulfate and add 2 to 3 drops of water to it. Then see the change. On adding water, it was observed that the blue color of copper sulfate is restored, means it comes back again. Hence, it was proved that the crystals of salts have some water and they are not really dry. So here they contain water in them, and when you are heating it, it releases water. Again, when you are adding water to the crystals, again they appear their color, they restore their color, original color. Hence we can say that the crystals of salts are really dry. From this we can define hydrated salts. So what are hydrated salts means? These salts containing water molecules are known as hydrated salts. Examples: Na2CO3, 10H2, sodium carbonate, washing soda, CaSO4, 2H2O, this is calcium sulfate. So here in the formula, you can see a fixed number. When I say washing soda, Na2CO3, 10H2O, CaSO4, 2H2O. So this fixed number of water molecules which are chemically attached to it is known as water of crystallization. So what is water of crystallization? The fixed number of water molecules which are chemically attached to each formula unit of a salt in its crystalline form. You should remember this also. In crystalline form, the fixed number of water molecules that are chemically attached to each formula unit of salt is known as water of crystallization. So in the above example, the water of crystallization of Na2CO3 10H2O is 10, and in this molecule the water of crystallization is 2. Okay, you have seen that two molecules with water of crystallization Na2CO3 10H2O and the other one CaSO4 2H2O, which is known as gypsum. This has two water molecules in its crystal and the formula is CaSO4 2H2O. Now see the use of it. Gypsum, on careful heating to 273 kelvins, it loses water molecules partially to become calcium sulfate hemihydrate. So here, when you are heating gypsum to 273 kelvins, it loses water molecules partially, not totally. Partially it loses water molecules and forms a new compound which is known as plaster of Paris. See, you can see in the sentence above one, when gypsum is heated to 273 kelvins, it loses water molecules partially. So gypsum contains actually two water molecules, but when we are heating to 273 kelvins, it loses partially and retains half of the water molecule, and the new formed compound is known as plaster of Paris, and its formula is CaSO4 half H2O. This plaster of Paris, in short, can be denoted as POP, and this is a white powder, and on mixing this with water, it sets into a hard solid mass due to the formation of gypsum. So when you are adding water molecules, it again comes back to its original form as gypsum. Now let's see uses of plaster of Paris, POP. POP is used for making toys, in making materials for decoration. How they are useful is, see, toys and decorative materials will be of different designs and shapes. So it has to be molded, and that molding is possible with POP, because when water is mixed to it, when it is in gypsum, so here when water is mixed to it, it can be molded very easily. It turns to a smooth paste and useful for molding. And after it gets molded, it attains some shape. Then this has to be dried very quickly. So POP has the property to dry quickly. Due to this properties, it is used for making toys and for decorative materials. It is also useful for making the surfaces smooth and waterproof also. POP can absorb water, so it is useful for waterproof materials. So in this way, plaster of Paris and the other chemicals which are extracted from common salt are helpful for us in many ways. With this, we have come to the end of the chapter, acid, bases and salts. Now what you need to do is go through the textbook available in the net. Okay, thank you.